Hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Victoria 2, the Grand Combination, with me, Alpha Bio Omega, and the Ottoman Empire. So in the previous episodes, we've actually managed to conquer, or, I mean, not conquer, but subjugate the territories of Serbia and Greece, and today we are gonna go ahead and conquer Zaidi. We already have our army going, so that's the plan for today's episode. Actually, they're not yet going, but we're gonna send them. Oh no, they're already going. Good. Which is a part of our expansion. I mean, it's just gonna be a couple of provinces, but they have some much needed grain and some decent coffee to add to the mix. So I'm hoping that it's gonna be good for us in the long run. Now I'm gonna unpause it. The game is gonna have a shock, as it usually does when you unpause it, because now it needs to recalculate all of the pops, because, you know, I just started a new session. But it's gonna hopefully fix itself. We get a decent amount of money saved. Oh wow, that actually was pretty quick. I don't really care about Natalia. And I have to say that I'm happy with the progress that they're making. Militance is low, conscientiousness is a little bit high, but, you know, not bad. Population is rising, and we are recruiting our fifth army? Yep, our fifth army. So we're doing our best to actually crawl up on that score. We're back to position 19, which is really, really good. And we're currently working on state and government because we desperately need more of those national focuses. We're going to get one extra, but there's two more that we can get from one of the discoveries or inventions. Not gonna reform the curricula. Let's keep it where it is. And generally speaking, you know, the alliance with United Kingdom is really good. Oh, all right. German Empire has been formed in 1867. Did they finish their war? They did. They did win their war, and they probably won because Schleswig is now part of Germany. Alright then, well, thank God we avoided the disaster of a war. Cool. So actually doing really good here. Do we have any projects to fund? Yes, we can fund a railroad in Adana. And, well, more unrest. I'm thinking that we might want to start funding some forts here and there. They're extremely expensive. But we might still be able to do it, though, you know, 10k is actually a really high and steep price, so we have to be really careful about where we fund it, especially at the beginning when our economy is so fragile. So let's focus on what we want to do right now, and that's the attack on our neighbor, Armenian history. Let's curtail the distribution. 35 regiments now. Oh yes, we're almost at 135k again. So, let's pause it and declare war on Zaidi, establish a protectorate. Do we want to call any allies? I don't think we really need to. So let's just go ahead and do it. I'll split you in half. You guys are gonna attack the army, and you guys are just gonna go ahead and siege. I think that's gonna be good enough. But the development bank, why the hell not? Let's fund it. I really don't understand the obsession about the heavy armaments industries. It's actually a pretty interesting thing to see happening. But alright, well, I mean, they have to, you know. I mean, it might be honestly just a coincidence that they are offering us these factories, because, I mean, they have to build something, so, you know. Political religion. Political religion is the doctrine that ties religion and political means together. Knowledge is often viewed as divinely given, and religion religious truth cannot be disproven. By the way, Utrin Mattis had an amazing suggestion which I didn't know about. He mentioned that if I click on yes, oh, that's really good. He suggested that if you go to the RGO map mode and you want to see where else you're getting a certain amount of provinces, when you click on it, it's going to show you provinces which produce it as well. And they should even be color-coded to show the amount that's produced there. So that's pretty interesting. I didn't know about this functionality at all. Turns out, where's the most grain produced? Over here. But I like this. That's a great function. Oh my god. Yeah, there's always going to be some crazy, insane, super strong provinces producing massive amounts. Alright, but you know what we could look at? We could look at sulfur if we can find it. Because I believe that actually might be something where we could play a vital role. The where the hell is sulfur? That's a great question. Alright, Izmit is producing sulfur. Oh yeah, alright, we're not doing that bad. Producing a decent amount in Aydin. Some over here in Mosul. You guys are producing some. Ah, so we have just two provinces producing it. That's interesting. I thought it would be a little bit more prevalent. Okay, and coffee. It's most in Africa. But looking at that, we could potentially get more of those. Interesting. Interesting, interesting. Alright, an alliance from Netherlands. Now I want to see who Netherlands are aligned with, and based on that we can decide. They are in Sphere of United Kingdom, so that's why we are going to accept it. Alright, so how's the battle going? Extremely well, though we're having a big issue with the terrain, but nothing major. Alright, Lanfang. The Lanfang Tor. The dictatorship is not what it used to be. Increased pluralism combined with extended political reform have led to the dictatorship more and more taking on the trappings of democracy. How very sad. Alright, I'm gonna increase the funding of the military to 70% so that we can actually make them get some experience. Alright, well, our army is growing stronger. I have to figure out where all of you are. Okay, you're already here. So three regiments already recruited. So you guys ought to be reinforced a little. I like that. Taxes-wise, we are really doing great. Individualism. Individualism is a belief in the importance of the individual and the virtue of self-reliance and personal independence. This doctrine also states that the government should not interfere in commercial affairs. Suppression efficiency -5%. Yeah, I'm not very interested in paying for that. Alright, so Zaidi will be a part of our realm now. So we gained Sana'a and we gained Al-Hudaida. Alright, so we're producing 2 units of coffee. Actually, let me see what the differences are in some of those RGO outputs, because I'm really interested. Alright, so if we look, for example, on tobacco, so we're producing 2.9 units here, 4.2, 5.7. So what kind of territory produces the most? So you guys are also not really producing, yeah, they're not even producing any. You are, you're producing, and we cannot see. Alright, I thought that we could, but unfortunately we can't. Never mind then. So you guys get back in here. And we'll keep it to ourselves. Alright, but with that said, I think that it's time we start the mysterious lands of Guatemala. When the Panama Canal was planned, several expeditions were sent into the regions of Central America. The inhabitants of the large jungles of Yucatan narrate stories of old cities and treasures. Adventurers and tomb raiders crossed and exposed these remote areas and found ruins or stelas. This news may be interesting for British archaeologists. Well, I would bet they are. Alright, money-wise, we're really doing great now. I'm happy about that. You guys need to reinforce, and we are going to send you back here. To reunite that army over there. Alright, let's kill this a little bit. Let's say we funded by 50. Eastern phrase, heavy armaments, fine. I don't think that's a great idea, but production 2.5. Well, on the other hand, there's not that much on the market. Alright, I'll fund it. I'll fund it, and I'll also fund Fort Iskun in Kostenje, and I'll fund a fort. Could fund two forts on the border of Russia here. England issue. It needs to build four. Which, I mean, honestly speaking, we can afford it, but I'm just going to do it, like, step by step. Let's not over-exert ourselves. Alright. Loading more railroads. That's always good. Max out. Max out. Max out. Development bank and more development banks and a university and the railroad and a development bank. Alright, let's get more usage points. About halfway through, it was 1869, right? Yeah. Alright, 12-pounder, nice! That's what we needed to see. The 12-pound cannon is a cannon that fires 12-pound projectiles from its barrel, as well as grapeshot, chainshot, shrapnel, and later shells and canister shots. So heavy armament, attack, and defense plus 0.3. Okay, more development banks, because we need that. Now, after we're done with the state and government, we need to go back to the army. I think strategic mobility could be good, because the field fortifications are great, they will help with defense for all of our units. But breech-loaded rifles could be even better. Yeah, but again, that's gonna be more expensive, so let's go with... No, let's go with military plans. Then we're gonna go with ad hoc banknote printing. Then we're gonna go with strategic mobility. Then we're gonna go with business banks. Or maybe something like urban rail or the high pressure steam. Oh, let's take it step by step. We need everything, that's the issue. I don't really care, they can go bankrupt and they won't. Kingdom of Sardinia. Who are they in the sphere of? No one. They have a really strong military though, way stronger than us. That's strict discipline. Portugal, and I think Portugal is allied with United Kingdom, aren't they? Yep, so we'll take it. Let's lower the amount of intellectuals. Let's put you guys back where you belong. Unite you guys into an army. And boy, can we recruit more units now. Alright. It makes me happy. We still have an issue with a number of the populations which just cannot support the population that it's supposed to, but whatever. And I think we're bound for actual tax cuts. Chartist rallies. Let them hold their little rally. And I'll decrease the taxes by 5%. Actually, 10% for the upper class. middle class, and this is going to significantly help with the promotions, and also roleplay reason is going to be that, yeah, the amount of them that can get their everyday needs and luxury needs and so on should increase, which in turn should help with the militancy eventually. Social conscience is the motivation deriving logically from ethical and moral principles that govern society as well as individual thoughts and actions. So suppression efficiency is lowered, which is just freaking amazing. Let's continue building those railroads because we have to. I'll fund more universities, development banks. I have to say, the thing that's actually making the difference is the national focus. I find that just the actual investment into military would help greatly, but without the focus, they tend not to really go all in on it. So it is worth actually looking at it. Alright, now let me see the sulfur areas, because those are the ones that we want. So there was one in Izmit. I'm gonna expand the development bank here, because that one helps with the output. And let's build the railroad, because that also helps. And I'd really like you to provide us with as much as you can. And Mosul is ours as well, so development bank and railroad. Do we have any more? Okay, our robot, it's not ours. So let's focus on the a little bit more rare things that we produce. What else could be a good one as far as raw materials go? Alloys, cement, not those are sulfur. Precious goods. Okay, we produce those in Constantinia. That's it? Really? Alright, I thought we had them in more places, but looks like it's not true. Alright, you have some use of pun nationalists. Alright, that might as well happen. I'm gonna pretend like it's not gonna happen. Silk. Why do we produce silk? That is also a fairly. Okay, there's silk over here and in some other places. Alright, so you have everything. You can get the development bank. And you can get the railroad and development bank. Alright, that's gonna increase the production. Kingdom of Sardinia. Absolutely not. Alright. Could get more regiments. So we get 3, 1, 2. So if I want, I need 2 and 2 more, and we'll have another full army. So let's get 2 more Turkish units and 2. Actually, let's get the Mashriki heavy armament. The gate. Cretan Revolution. The Christian Cretans have risen up together with the rest of the Greece in the Greek Revolution of 1821. But despite success in the countryside, the Ottomans held out in the 4 fortified towns of the northern coast, and the island was eventually reconquered in 1828, becoming an Egyptian province. Another uprising later secured some privileges, such as the right to bear arms, equality of Christian and Muslim worship, and the establishment of Christian councils of elders with jurisdiction over education and customary and family law. These concessions were resented by the Muslim community, but the Christians pressed for more while maintaining their ultimate aim of union with Greece. As tensions ran high in the island, and several petitions to the Sultan were unanswered, armed bands were formed, and the uprising was officially proclaimed in the year of 1867. Crush the rebels. Greece shall be free. I don't really know what they think they're doing. They have no army. But alright, if you think that's a good idea, I'll not be mad at you. Alright, we'll probably burn the rest of our money here, so we'll have to increase the taxes again. But I'm happy that I could at least for some time lower the taxes. Damn, we're built. Look at how many things we're building. That's crazy. Alright, I should have probably split my armies for this, but alright. Good that the projects are actually working, because that's gonna help us significantly. At least in the short run. Let's build a paper factory, and build a university, and build a development bank. And another development. Wow. Staff, it's actually crazy. Max it out, and I'm gonna increase the taxes by 5%. For middle and for lower class. Alright, so you're sieging, and then you're gonna siege here and reconquer the island. Okay, can we increase relations with... there's no need to increase relations with Russia. Let's increase them with France. And I think we've had a little bit of a hiccup with our biggest ally, United Kingdom. So let's get that. How's our infamy? Jesus Christ. Yeah, we can't really do anything. Until we bleed it off. God, that's crazy. I don't know what they think they're doing, honestly. They're gonna be just ruffle stomped. But, alright, well, they think it's gonna help the national unity. I won't protest. Or the luxury clothing factory in Southwest Macedonia sounds like a good idea, but I can't really invest in you guys right now. We don't have the money for that. Okay, Crete will be annexed. Awesome, and it didn't even cost us anything. So it's lower investment to 50%, so that you guys don't really get worn out, and once you reinforce, we're gonna be done. Alright, I mean, militancy is still sticking low. Well, we have a ton and ton of projects going, which is just amazing. The economy is just booming right now, which I won't lie, is a great thing to see. We have, what, 145,000 almost soldiers left. You guys will reinforce, and we are going to cut the investment. Alright. We'll keep the taxes a little bit higher for now, so that we can build up that stockpile again. Alright, building another factory. Yeah, three heavy Ottomans factory. That's just... No, we have more. One, two, three, four, five. Alright, someone wants to control the market. That is insane. That is insane. But hey, you know, you do what you have to. Oh! Cement and fertilizer industries. Alright, I think those might be a good idea. The one in Diyarbakir I'm gonna fund. Let's use Serbian for now. Do you have enough money for these? We don't. So just fund the universities and we're gonna fund the fertilizer factory afterwards. Come on. I have a feeling the taxes and the issues that we actually made go away has a lot to do with this. So we'll see how it's gonna go. Alright, well, on that note, I think I'm gonna end the episode here. We'll finish that army. And oh my god, our army is starting to look nicer. 145k. We need to get to at least where we were before. And we would like to get to at least like position 15, 14 before I'm gonna feel a little bit more confident. Because, you know, military, we're doing great. I think that, yeah, 16th strongest nation, but prestige-wise, lesser power Christian. Oh god, we're bleeding out, actually, our prestige. Huh. Well, alright, that is an issue. Not much I can do with that, though, just continuously work on increasing it. Well, and Wallachia is gonna be the next big thing for us, but that's not gonna happen without a proper war with Russia, which they got almost a million troops. We got what? 70k. All right, well, that's gonna have to wait.